Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger, and today we're going to have a quiz. This is only our second quiz, but now is a good chance for us to consolidate a lot of things that we've been doing. We have a good command of rational trigonometry, I hope, and now is a chance for you to put it into practice. These problems on this quiz are not so cut and dried. They're not completely elementary. They will be a little bit challenging. They will be also interesting. So much better than doing Sudoku or crossword puzzles or what have you. These are problems that you can get your teeth into. You can spend a fair amount of time analyzing them. And there's many possibilities for further extension and exploration. So there's a lot to do with this quiz, all right? Don't think that you can just do it quickly. And remember that in rational trigonometry, we're interested in correct answers. That means decimal approximations are of little interest. We want to know what the exact answers are. So, problem one. It's called the 6-7-8 triangle. It deals with a triangle A1, A2, A3, whose side lengths are 6, 7, and 8. So these are the distances. And we suppose that we have a bisector, vertex bisector at A3. That's a line so that these two spreads are equal, or if you like, these two angles are equal, meeting the other line over here at B. And then over here we have a median. A1 to C is a median. In other words, these two lengths are both 3. And these two lines, the median and the vertex bisector, meet at a point D, and we would like to know what is the distance between A2 and D. And if you work that out, then you can try to generalize the situation by replacing 6, 7, 8 with another triangle whose lengths are going up incrementally, say K, K plus 1, K plus 2. And if you figure that out, then you can, as a further challenge, try to calculate all the quadrants and spreads in the diagram. This second problem I call squares in a pentagon, and it was inspired by a beautiful mosque that I visited once in Malaysia, and that had a beautiful Islamic pattern on it, of which this is a sort of a simplified version. I might talk about that more complicated situation some other time. So we have a circle, and we have a regular pentagon in the circle, A, B, C, D, so each side is of length D, another distance. And then what we do is we construct squares. So in the middle of each one of these segments, we construct a square, so that's centrally located. And that square is just so big so that it touches a similar square built on the adjacent side. So all these squares are congruent, and they meet at these corners, which we call F, G, H, I, and J. And we suppose that the side of the square is of length E. So the question is, what is the ratio D to E? And another, perhaps a little bit more complicated problem, what is the ratio of the two radii of the circle? The radius of the big circle divided by the radius of this inscribed littler circle. And if you work that out, then you can also perhaps ask yourself, what happens if we replace squares with pentagons and the pentagon with a hexagon? So in other words, where we consider a pattern of pentagons inscribed inside a hexagon, also symmetrically located like this, each one. Our third problem was actually suggested to me by a reader or a listener of these videos. It's called trisecting a right triangle. So here's a right triangle, ABC, with the right vertex at C. And we imagine that this vertex at A is trisected by these two lines. So equal spreads, or if you prefer, equal angles. And the only thing that we know about this situation is that if these two points down here are called D and E, then we know that the quadrants between B and D is 11, and the quadrants between D and E is, say, 5. And we're interested in what is the quadrants between E and C. And you can generalize that by not looking at 11 and 5, but rather looking at a general value R1 and R2 for these two quadrants, and then try to figure out this third quadrant in terms of R1 and R2. And our fourth and final problem we call flexible quadrilateral problem. We have a quadrilateral with side lengths 5, 9, 8, and 7. And the other thing that we know about this quadrilateral is that the two diagonals meet at 60 degrees, or a spread of 3/4. And what we'd like to do is to like to find the distance between A and C, and between B and D. In other words, the length of these diagonals. And then we'd like to generalize that, if you can. I think these problems suggest that there's quite a rich possibility in studying problems exactly. I hope you have fun with them, and next time we'll talk about the solutions. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.